Marijuana is the most commonly used drug in the United States, and its use is growing rapidly. This means that many women of reproductive age are using marijuana. Does marijuana make it more difficult to become pregnant? Will it increase the risk of miscarriage or other pregnancy complications? Stay tuned. For adults aged 19 to 30, the use of marijuana in the past year was reported by approximately 44% of those surveyed in 2022. This is up from 28% just 10 years earlier. About 10% of people in this age group reported using marijuana every day. For people over age 30, use of marijuana has also increased. That is a lot of marijuana use in people who might become pregnant or are actively trying to get pregnant. Studying the effect of marijuana use is difficult because in some states, marijuana is not yet legalized for recreational use. People in those states are less likely to admit to marijuana use to researchers, and this can have an effect on the results of these studies. The most useful studies are those that do blood testing for THC, the main compound in marijuana. Unfortunately, there are very few of those studies that have been performed. So what do these studies show? A study from 1990 found that women who had smoked marijuana within 1 year of trying to conceive were twice as likely to have infertility because of ovulation problems compared to women who did not use marijuana. More recently, researchers in Boston surveyed over 4,000 women who had been attempting pregnancy for a short period of time. They compared women who admitted to using marijuana less than once per week to those who used more than once a week. The probability of becoming pregnant each month was the same for both groups. Another study looked at over 1,000 women. About 11% admitted to marijuana use while trying to conceive. About 3% reported daily use. They did not find a difference in the average time it took to conceive in those that admitted to marijuana use. So, the weight of evidence suggests that female marijuana use does not make it more difficult to become pregnant, if we believe the women who denied using marijuana were telling the truth. None of these studies confirmed usage with blood or urine testing. More recently, researchers performed a study in which they asked women about their marijuana use with the question, but also did urine testing. Originally, these women were recruited for a different study about miscarriage, but the researchers were able to do additional analyses to look at this particular question. Women were followed for up to 6 menstrual cycles while attempting pregnancy and throughout pregnancy if conception occurred. In total, about 1,200 women were studied. But what were the results? About 5% of the women used marijuana before pregnancy. 42% of the women who used marijuana any time before conception became pregnant, whereas 66% of women who did not use marijuana became pregnant. In other words, marijuana use was associated with less people becoming pregnant over a 6-month time frame. This was true even after they adjusted for other factors like tobacco and alcohol use. They did not find any link with marijuana use before conception and miscarriage. The numbers weren't big enough to determine if marijuana use during early pregnancy led to more miscarriages. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: I don't think we have enough data about marijuana and fertility to draw definite conclusions, but there is some evidence that marijuana use may lower the chance for pregnancy. If you are trying to become pregnant or have infertility, it seems reasonable to avoid marijuana use while you are trying to conceive. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.